Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today I want to focus on the room and the noise, if you will, that the room makes. Our rooms contribute over 50% of what we hear inside of them. So it's important to understand just what their contribution is to the sound that we're hearing in the room. It's always that balance between direct and reflected energies, but all that energy in a box, the room, produces distortions. And today I want to focus on the four main distortions that our rooms cause. First one is room modes. These are the high and low pressure areas as a result of long wavelengths, low frequency energy not fitting into our smaller rooms. SBIE, speaker boundary interference effect. This is the distortion that's caused between the speakers in our room and the surfaces of our room. So we need to be cognizant of those issues. Comb filter, a series of reflections between two surfaces that looks like a comb, the teeth of a comb on a graph. So this is why it gets its name. And then finally, poor diffusion, probably the most misunderstood and just not understood at all concept in room acoustics. And it's so very, very important. It's the sound we want to get but don't have because of our room. So today we're going to elaborate on each of these four and give you a little bit more information on each one to help you understand their impact and effect. Okay, our first room distortion that we want to focus on is room modes. These are those high and low pressure areas in our room, and they're caused by long wavelengths, low frequency energy that simply doesn't want to fit correctly inside of our room. A 30 cycle wave, 37 foot long, 20 foot longest dimension of a room. Some is going to fit, some is not. So some will go through the wall, a lot will go through the wall, and some will be reflected back into the room and contained within the room. And it's this energy that we need to focus on because it's this energy that creates the pressure areas. If we look at this pressure map, you can see that the pressure areas are everywhere throughout the room. And these are pressure areas that we need to be aware of because they can mask, smother, and blur certain frequencies that are present within them, so to speak. So we really need to be careful of those pressure areas and how they interact with what we're trying to accomplish. There's ways to reduce them. There's technologies that we can use to reduce them. First, you have to find out where they are in the room, and then you have to apply the correct treatment. So room modes, first type of room acoustic distortion that must be dealt with, and we do have the technologies to deal with it, but location is critical, and then magnitude, defining how big they are so we can assign the proper technology to absorb it. Our second room distortion that we want to look at has a long name, SBIE, which stands for speaker boundary interference effect. So it's an acronym for the issues that go on between our speakers and our room boundary surfaces. These can be all kinds of issues. They can produce comb filters, which we will discuss in the next room distortion. We can also look at pressure areas created by low frequency energy that gets trapped and built up in these areas. So the distance from the speaker or sound generating device or source to the room boundary surface has a huge impact on what you hear. If you want to test this out, it's real easy. All you have to do is measure the room's frequency response when you have your speakers set up in a certain position, and then just go ahead and move your speakers maybe a foot forward more towards the center of the room and look at the frequency response of the room now, and you'll see a big difference. So there's a lot of energy in this area and it also always needs to be controlled with the proper acoustic technology. And this energy that's trapped between the speaker and the room boundary surfaces can also be the ceiling and the floor, produces what we call phantom images. So it kind of has a sound, if you will, of its own. Now, it's not audible, and I mean, it is audible, but it doesn't sound like a speaker, but it has a particular coloration and quality to it, because when it's not there and treated correctly, you can definitely hear the difference. So speaker boundary interference effect, the distortion, if you will, that occurs between the speaker and your room boundary surface. So we need to be aware of those issues also. Okay, our third room distortion that we want to talk about in regards to rooms and the noise, if you will, that they produce is something called a comb filter. A comb filter is a series of reflections back and forth, back and forth, back and forth between two opposing surfaces. So if we take our speakers here and we look at left and right channel, we can notice that energy from a speaker is always radiated out of the cabinet, front, sides, rear, especially with the lower frequencies, omnidirectional out of the speaker. The mids and the highs pretty much out of the front, but low frequency energy out of this. And of course, we have our sidewall reflections with middles and highs. But it's this back and forth trapping, if you will, of energy that creates another phantom image situation as similar to speaker boundary interference effect that we just discussed. So all of these areas of trapped energy and noise, if you will, in and of them by themselves, probably not too big of a deal, but it's the accumulation of a lot of these little issues that add up to a big room distortion issue in your playback and recording environment. So we want to be a little bit anal and address all these little issues so that they don't add up to be a big issue. Another area that's completely misunderstood and overlooked is diffusion. I think people just don't understand diffusion. They don't understand how to apply it. But it's really necessary in all our small rooms and even large room environments. Diffused sound energy is present in free space or outside, if you will. There's objects everywhere. There's the earth, there's trees, there's buildings. Everything is diffused. The energy is bouncing everywhere. And our brain and ears are trying to localize all this energy and does a pretty good job of it. When we take that outside world and we shrink it down into a room or a small box, we change all the physics. We change all the physics of our ear. So we have to compensate for going from an outside large environment that's really diffused in terms of sound energy into a small box with small dimensions and restricted distances for frequencies to travel. People just don't understand the power of diffusion and what it can do in a room. It can do many, many things. One of the things it can do is it can add separation to your instruments and vocals. Because if you're talking outside to three or four people 5 feet away, they're able to understand all your words and hear everything intelligently, hopefully, and acoustically. But when you get into a small room, you have early, late, and direct sound energies impacting upon the listening environment. So you need to create an environment that has diffusion in it. And one of the ways to do that is with diffusion technology. Separation, definition. Definition is another thing that it will do for you. It helps define the mid-range area quite nicely, and it also adds what we call air or spaciousness. So diffusion, and we like to use quadratic diffusion because it's predictable and consistent. You can actually choose the frequency response you wish to diffuse, and this is really helpful in certain rooms depending on usage. So I'm going to show you a diffuser And we'll talk a little bit about quadratic diffusion. This is our DIY diffuser kit. This diffusion sequence is based on the prime number 7. We will be offering this shortly on our website. It's a kit that you actually build yourself. It's very easy. All you need is glue and a little bit of masking tape to hold the pieces together while they dry. We finish each piece for you. We cut it to fit, and you can watch the videos on that and how to assemble it. We'll have 3 sequences for you right out of the gate shortly. One based on prime 7, one based on prime 11, and one based on prime 13. Just a little bit, as the numbers go up, the diffuser gets wider, the wells get deeper, the diffusion frequencies get a little bit more involved. So you're going to have 3 to pick from, but this is a quadratic diffuser, and 4 of these across the back wall in a recording studio or control room. Amazing what it will do to the rear wall, that bounce back. You won't even believe there's a rear wall there. Front and rear wall in listening environments. Oh my gosh, it just opens up the presentation. There's definition, there's separation, there's all kinds of good things that go on with diffusion. So diffusion's not that hard if you have the right kind of tool, and quadratic diffusion is a really, really good tool because it's predictable and consistent. And now in kit form, you can just buy it and assemble it in your studio or home and have a finished unit, and then using 3 or 4 or 5 units positioned in your room, you can achieve a nice diffuse sound field in your room.